I'd like to start by acknowledging that we meet on the country of the Kaurna people of the Adelaide Plains. We recognise and respect their cultural heritage and relationship to the land and acknowledge their continuing importance of that to the Kaurna people living today. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Pat Buckley. I'm the Dean of Graduate Studies here at UniSA, and the first thing I have to say is a big welcome and thanks. A welcome to our presenters for the afternoon, Taruna, Alex, Justin and Andrea, who are here to tell you about some very prestigious scholarship opportunities available for undergraduate and postgraduate students. A thank you to Kelly and her team for organising this event, and a warm welcome and thank you to you for turning up on a Friday afternoon to hear about these scholarships. You've actually been specially invited to come, so these are prestigious scholarships and we have targeted the audience for this particular event. So why do we host an event like this? I think it probably tracks with that word prestigious. And what that tells you is a few things. So the scholarships you're going to hear about today have real traction. They're understood nationally. They're understood internationally. They have, through their longevity, their backers, and the pedigree of people who have achieved the scholarships and done great work with them, really acquired a very prestigious status in our ether. And what that means really is that if you have the opportunity to avail of a scholarship like this, it says automatically something about you to other people. So if you're able to say, if you say something like, I had a Fulbright scholarship, in many ways, you nearly not need to say much else because it's sending some clear signals about your quality and the level of achievement you've had to demonstrate to secure a scholarship like that. The other thing these scholarships are highly enabling. And I think they're enabling of three things: research, career, and networks. So these are the sort of scholarships that can allow you expand your ideas and test your ideas, often in places where there are experts and resources that aren't available to you locally. There are networks you get introduced to and which you become part of through scholarship opportunities such as these. We have a staff member in the university, Professor Jennifer McKay. Some of you may know her. Jennifer, many, many years ago, got a Fulbright scholarship, and she still talks about the networks of people she met and maintains to this day as collaborators and friends through that experience. And I hear that again and again. And in terms of career, you know, it's competitive and you're all here because you're doing well and you're ambitious for yourselves. So in terms of career, these scholarships are the things that make CVs stand out. I sit on a lot of selection panels, and what you're looking for amongst a group of really great applicants are those that pop. And these kind of scholarships make CVs pop. So as you sit and hear and question the presenters about the talks they're going to give you today, just take the time to sit with the schemes you're being introduced to and think about yourself and your interests and which of any of the schemes you think you might, your interests might map onto. And then there's the beyond today piece. The beyond today piece is the activation step, and can be a little bit hard to know how do I go about that. Really, if you think there's a scholarship that you're hearing about today that you're interested in, the most important thing is to tell a couple of people about that, because we will help you prepare that application. We'll help you test it, sense check it, and help you build an application to its most competitive level. So enjoy the afternoon, and my thanks once again to our presenters for coming along. Thank you.